Are you enjoying it so far?
Yes.
I was talking to Joe. What? 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 I know he was a bit of a div. We'll extricate him yet. This was one of his favorite songs when he used to get together at parties. If mine, let me see if I can find a key for you. If my health is spared, I'll be long relating of the boat that sailed out from Anakakuan, and the keening after of mother and father as the laying out of each corpse was done. O King of Graces, O die to save us. It was a small affair for but one or two. But a boatload bravely on a calm day sailing, without storm or rain to be swept to doom. It was in the 1840s it happened. Before Lent, all the couples who had to get married or wanted to get married or had to want to get married, they had to go down into Galway for the fair. It was a time of great celebration and a great sheep fair. They were bringing the boat down from the Corrib down into Galway. And the little pattering of the sheep's sharp hoofs were on the bottom of the boat. Of course, the old boat was rotten. One of the hoofs went through, and one of the crew members jumped down. He took off the frieze jacket. He jammed it into the hole, went to stamp it home with the heel of his shoe or his pampooty, and the bottom of the boat went down within 100 yards of shore. On a calm day, 11 men and 8 women died. But to Raftery, who wrote the song about it, he wrote into it the death of every man, the death of everyone. The boat sprang a leak and left all those people and frightened sheep out adrift on the tide. It beats all telling what fate befell them, 11 strong men and 8 women to die. Men who could manage the plough and harrow to break the fallow and scatter seed, and women whose fingers were deft and nimble to spin fine linen and frieze to weave. And young boys were lying when crops were ripening from the strength of youth. They were born to clay. In their wedding clothes for their wake, they robed them. O King of Glory, man's hope is vain. May burning mountains come tumbling down on that place of drowning. May curses fall for many a soul that is filled with mourning and left without hope of a bright day's dawn. The cause of their fate was no fault of sailing, It was the boat that failed them at Cochlannua. And it left me to make with a heart that's breaking this lamentation.